Welcome to Hard Knocks Fighting TV. My name is Jeremy Ballantyne. On today's episode of Hard Knocks Rising Stars, we profile a Hard Knocks fighter on their journey through the Hard Knocks cage. On this episode, we're featuring Felix Jimenez. Felix fights out of Estevan, Canada. Here to discuss Felix with me is CEO of Hard Knocks Fighting, Ari Tope. Ari, Felix Jimenez, an outstanding athlete, but an untraditional way he got into MMA. He started as a baseball player.
Right. He's a very, very good athlete. I don't know that there's many baseball players that actually progress to MMA, but nonetheless, I think he's got a striking background and he's quick and he moves well. And what we've seen out of him the last couple of years is an increasing understanding of cage control and takedown defense and some of the things that are going to make him a dominant heavyweight as things progress.
Well, I asked Felix how hard he could throw a baseball, and he said somewhere in the range of 85 to 87 miles an hour. So if you can imagine that as an overhand right hand, you can understand the striking power of Felix Jimenez.
Yeah, like I said, he's big and he's a good athlete.
So on today's episode, we feature Felix Jimenez.
In the Power Dodge Blue Corner, he's 3-3 as an amateur, 28 years old, and 61 inches tall. He weighed in at 209 pounds, fighting out of Jeff Willis Jiu-Jitsu in Regina. Please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Derek the Lion Parker! In the Boston Pizza Red Corner is his amateur debut. He's 35 years old, 10'6", 1 inches tall. He weighed in at 208 pounds, fighting out of Southeast Combat Sports in Estevan. Please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Felix Jimenez! His double he contested under amateur rules. The referee in charge of the Hard Knocks action is Mr. Elvis Lyons.
Gentlemen, to the center of the cage.
So Elvis Lyon in charge of the action in the center of the cage. A reminder, amateur rules here in Estevan, Saskatchewan. No knees to the head of a downed opponent. That's pretty much one of the unified rules of MMA. Also, you do get to see some ground and pound here in Estevan and in, throughout all of our events here in Saskatchewan. Felix coming across with a big kick early. That misses. Parker again seems to be loading that right hand. Spinning back fist from Parker. That doesn't connect, though. Both fighters continuing to mix it up and feel each other out here in the early going of round number one. 3 3-minute rounds for our amateurs here in Estevan. Felix coming forward with another kick, really working that Muay Thai background. You can see as he continues, Parker lands a nice right hand in there on Felix. He gets that nice solid right hand in. We'll see how Felix handles that, dancing forward a little bit, throws a kick, starts to run away. Superman punch now thrown by Parker. Again, so far so good for Felix the Cat in against a tough opponent. 6 fights, 3-3 record for Derek Parker. Oh, another spinning back fist attempted. That one blocked by Jimenez as he was coming for a kick of his own, and now Felix has him up against the cage. Some punches landing there, and nice takedown there by Felix. He finds himself in the guard of Parker. Parker now trying to scramble back towards the fence. No doing, says Felix. Couple punches landed either way, but neither one of them really landing anything significant. Again, just 3 3-minute rounds, and with the feeling out process, Felix is going to have to work here pretty quickly. Parker trying to scramble back up. Felix doing a nice job of holding him down. The debut fighter from Estevan, Saskatchewan, doing an excellent job here in the early going on top of the more experienced fighter. Now trying to potentially land a choke. Felix dropping punches. Nice, a big left hand there from Felix as he continues to go, but a sweep now by Parker. Parker now on top, and he's landing some punches. He's in the full mount. Jimenez grabs him and takes him down, pulls him back down to the ground, looking for a sweep of his own now. But unsuccessful. And Parker continues to work from the top position. He's got one of Jimenez's arms pinned, and he starts punching. Got to watch those punches to the back of the head. Felix now tries to scramble out. Parker does a good job of staying on top. Felix, though, proving to be wily from the bottom, but Parker doing a good job of holding him down in the mount. Again, Parker trying to get an arm loose, lands one hammer fist, but not much damage on that one, just a glancing blow. Again, has him up against the cage, now has one knee on his arm. Felix doing a good job to scramble out, but he's gonna have to watch out and not try and give up his back. Now Parker looking for a choke, flattens Jimenez out, has the rear naked choke. We'll see if Felix can tap from here or if Derek will be able to finish this fight off. Again, gave up the choke, and that's the end of round one. We're through one here at Hard Knock 16 in Estevan, Saskatchewan. Derek Parker raising his hand in victory as he walks over to his corner. Jimenez looking pretty gassed in his corner as he's taking some deep breaths. The amateur making his debut tonight in front of the hometown fans. Doing a pretty good job in round number one. Found himself in some trouble spots, but did some a nice job scrambling, especially when Parker had the full mount, doing a good job of getting away from it, staying away from that mounted position. And we'll see here how quickly he can recover between rounds. You can see him taking some deep breaths. One of the focuses on some of the big jiu-jitsu camps is really getting that breath back. So Elvis Lyon ready for round number two as we get set. And we are again underway. Round number two here in the first fight of the night at the School of Hard Knocks 16, a presentation of the Hard Knocks Fighting Championship. Jimenez in the black trunks, Parker in the tight gray shorts, as again hasn't fought from since 2008, can probably find himself some new equipment. Now again, Jimenez circling, trying to cut Parker off in the cage. Parker doing a good job of staying clear. Again, a good striking background for both of these fighters here. Jimenez faking the takedown. Parker looked like he was ready, so Jimenez backs off a bit. Nice fist coming in. More fists now from Parker as he lands a couple blows up against the cage and heads back out to center. Big knee there. Felix tries to sweep Parker down, but ends up on the wrong side of that, and he's back in the mount. And this time it's a bad situation up against the cage. Felix has one hand, he's trying to hold him down, and we'll see what Parker can do from here. Lots of time left on the clock here as Parker in the full mount, looking like he's trying a choke from the top. Again, trying to crank on Jimenez's neck, maybe make the amateur make a mistake. Felix tries to flip over, but is unsuccessful. Parker still in the mount. Just effectively trying to ruin the energy system of Jimenez, but now Parker starts to land some shots. Parker putting Jimenez's mouth guard back in there. There's some sportsmanship that you might not find somewhere else. Again, more punches landing from the top from Parker. Straight rights, hammer fists, a couple lefts getting in there as well. And again, more punches to the head of Jimenez. Elvis Lyon right on top of the action. But so far, Felix Jimenez defending successfully. Derek Parker now yelling at the referee. I believe he said he's got a wife and kids, stop it. But Elvis Lyon not yet jumping in. A nice reversal there from Jimenez, but just gets a hammer fist for his trouble as Parker retains the mount. Again, Parker continuing to drop bombs on Jimenez, who has not much in the way of defense in this position. And again, Derek Parker yelling at the referee, and this time that'll do it. Elvis Lyon steps in, and Derek Parker gets the victory. He'll move to 4-3. Felix the Cat Jimenez finds himself on the wrong end of some ground and pound, and he'll have to go back to the drawing board on getting out of that mounted position as he finds himself falling to 0-1 as an amateur.
Guys, really good fight.
The winner by TKO due to ref stoppage due to strikes at 2 minutes and 25 seconds in the second round. In the blue corner, Derek Parker!
Good job, guys.
Let's go, Felix!
Why did you start fighting? Who introduced you to mixed martial arts?
I always was into fighting. I always did martial arts, like Taekwondo and stuff like that. Nothing crazy, but just watching my wife, cousin Jesse Bonfield, the last time he fought in the UFC, got me really thinking about that I should be doing that. So, and I got into it. So, since I was really young, I started playing balls. I used to play from, I'm from the Dominican Republic, so I used to play, like, we used to go to Puerto Rico to play from the time that I was 12 to 16. Then I came to Canada and then I started training and then started playing for like independent teams. And I went back to the Dominican, signed with the Phillies, a minor league contract, got released, back to the minor league, back to the Northern League, and then stuck there.
What did you think when Felix first told you that he wanted to be a mixed martial artist?
I didn't really agree with it, to tell you the truth. He'd been telling me for quite some time, this just didn't start overnight. He's been for years doing martial arts and doing all that kind of stuff. And then over the years, he's just such a big fan of the sport that he just really wanted to get into it. And he's been aggressive before and really enjoys that type of sport. So he just sprung it on me one day that, look, I'm fighting at Hard Knocks Fighting. I was like, oh, okay.
He is a quick learner. Like, you, it's kind of like a blank paper. And then once you write down what you want him to do, he would do it right away. And I like it. Like, it's whatever I was teaching him, he's observing it right away.
More about Hard Knocks Fighting and upcoming Hard Knocks events, please visit hardknocksfighting.com.
In the Power Dodge blue corner, he's 1-0 as an amateur, 25 years old, and stands 6 feet 3 inches tall. He weighed in at 256.5 pounds, fighting as an independent from Moose Jaw. Please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Steven Arns! And in the Boston Pizza red corner, he's 0-1 as an amateur, 35 years old, and stands 6 feet 2 inches tall. He weighed in at 228 pounds, fighting as an independent from your hometown, please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Felix the Cat Jimenez! This bout will be contested under amateur rules. The referee in charge of the Hard Knocks action is Mr. Lucien Phillips.
Lucien Phillips in charge of the cage, and as the cage doors close, we've got Steven Arns in the red and black trunks out of the blue corner. All red trunks for Felix Jimenez as he gets set to come out. Felix looking a little heavier than we've seen him in the past, and a big rush out from Arns. Again, former D lineman, so you know he's going to be quick off the run, but Felix with a nice takedown there, working his judo.
It's almost like Felix is expecting that rush as he pounded it pretty well and got a takedown out of it. And now he's trying to work on the offense on top of Arns on the ground here.
Jimenez on top of Arns after, again, a nice judo takedown. Some nice punches there from Felix. We know Arns has a chin as he took it on the chin several times against Wade Baldwin.
And right now, Felix not really getting too many shots and trying to get a good position. But Arns using his strength to hold off Felix here. And the ref kind of gets some movement here, but both men not getting a good grip.
Felix trying to find an opening and eventually gets a hand through. Arns doing a good job, though, of defending from here and not allowing much damage as he tries to get back to a full guard.
And Felix trying to get back on top here, but now some hands to the face there. And there's an incoincidental finger to the eye there, which the ref warned about. Now there's a shot there by Felix. And Arns trying to be careful here.
Jimenez still landing a couple shots from the top. Referee imploring them to work, and he does as he drops a couple punches.
It's kind of an awkward spot for Aaron. He's kind of half rolled on top on the cage there. So his leverage might be affected in trying to fend off these punches and use his strength to get out of this.
Again, doing a good job of wrist control for the most part on Felix, although Felix does now free a hand and start and landed a shot to the body. Both fighters now continuing to struggle here in the early going, halfway or almost through round number one. Just 1 minute left according to our endurance time clock.
And now trying to get an elbow here towards the neck area is Felix. Trying to discomfort Aaron as much as he can here, and there's a good shot.
That was a big left hand from Felix Jimenez.
And the impact definitely felt there by Aaron. He's got to avoid those at all costs. And he's sorry, go ahead.
So far, so good, I was going to say, for Felix, though, as he continues to be on top, as he has been now for about the last 2 minutes. An early flurry, an early bull rush from Steven Aarons left him open to a judo throw, which was executed by Felix. And after that, it's been all Felix Jimenez on top. And a good job of defense, but not going to score any points that way, is Steven Aarons.
And some noticeable marks on Aarons' forehead already, so there's some more shots. Felix looking really comfortable in this first round. Another shot.
So a great first round from Felix Jimenez, who puts together his most impressive performance in the Hard Knocks cage to date. Steven Aarons looking out a little upset with how that first round went, walked away shaking his head, but is still standing, which almost wasn't the case at the end of the first round in the Baldwin fight, as both fighters had kind of punched themselves out by that point. But it'll be interesting to see here in round number two, and we see here Felix Jimenez on top. I believe this is near the end of the first round, as Jimenez is going to look to posture up and land some strikes here in probably his biggest individual flurry while on top in round number one.
Yeah, he's got to be happy with his performance. Like you mentioned, that judo takedown just set everything up. And I'm sure Aaron's is feeling the effects of this. He used a lot of energy and didn't get much offense. And that's not a good combination you want, especially in against a man the size of Felix Jimenez.
So Jimenez again in the red trunks out of the red corner, red and black Death Clutch trunks for Steven Aarons, who is bleeding from the nose at this point in the fight, also breathing pretty heavy. It's an interesting flip from football to MMA. You move from 15-second plays to 3-minute rounds, and that's a really different type of athleticism required once you get in the cage.
And a bit more conservative burst out of the corner this time from Aarons, and now he's trying to get some shots in.
But the bull rush still coming, and now he's landing some punches. He has Jimenez up against the cage. Jimenez did land a nice leg kick early and had him down to one knee, but again, this is something that Aarons has done at a very high level, which is push against another man. But at that point, tripping was illegal, and Jimenez may have a choke in. He's trying to get that choke in deep, and we'll see whether or not Aarons taps here as the far hand looks like he's tapping. This fight is all over. Felix Jimenez gets the first win of his mixed martial arts career, and Steven Aarons will suffer from a guillotine choke, and Felix Jimenez celebrating in the center of the cage as he is ecstatic with his victory.
Yeah, he's fired up, and reason to be, he dominated that fight. First round on the ground, hammer and pounding, and then he caught him with the guillotine, it looks like. Ace. And Aaron's no choice but to tap, as Jimenez had that locked in very good.
Official,
here as we get
thank
the
you.
Replay
goes
now.
To the Days Inn, the official Hard Knocks Hotel for fighters and out-of-town guests. Their generosity with rooms for Hard Knocks fighters, staff, and fans is greatly appreciated. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the official decision brought to you by Endurance Oil Field. At 29 seconds in the second round, the winner, due to tap out via guillotine choke, in the red corner, Felix the Cat Jimenez!
How do you feel when your fighters step in the cage?
Confident and worried.
Those are two things that don't normally go hand in hand.
Exactly.
So confident of victory, but worried for their overall
yeah, overall well-being. I want him to, after he walks out from the ring, he is still the same as a low profile person. He is very humble. He's a giant, but he's a humble giant.
The fight with Derek Parker, which was Felix's first fight, he didn't come out on the top of that fight and was pretty beat up after that fight. Tell us a little bit about the reaction, your reaction afterwards, and how you kind of feel now when Felix steps in the fight after he's strung together a few victories.
Well, during that fight, I couldn't even control myself. I was just so worried, and it just seemed to go on and on and on. I was like, protect yourself, because I knew it was going very badly. And I've never seen him ever in a physical altercation that he's ever lost. So it was very surprising for me. But after that, I was really concerned about the damage that had been done to him in his eye and stuff like that. But he didn't seem to even stop him a bit, and he had more energy to keep going, and that loss really pushed him to work harder, and he didn't realize how intense of a sport it was, and he trained harder and harder, and so I had more confidence after that that he would do better.
And for that my first fight, I thought I was ready, but I wasn't ready. I never had to cut 19 pounds in 24 hours, so he wouldn't fight me the way that I was at, so I had to cut like 19 pounds in that 24 hour, and that was pretty harsh on me. So I like to get hit harder in the head and have to cut weight. So
to find out more about Hard Knocks Fighting and upcoming Hard Knocks events, please visit hardknocksfighting.com.
And now, the official Hard Knocks Fighter introductions. In the Power Dodge blue corner, he's 1-2 as an amateur, 36 years old, and stands 6'1" tall. He weighed in at 224 pounds, fighting as an independent from Estevan. Please welcome Hard Knocks Fighter, Felix the Cat Jimenez! And in the Boston Pizza red corner, he's 1-2 as an amateur, 35 years old, and stands 6'2" tall. He weighed in at 228 pounds, fighting out of Estevan Combat Sports, from Estevan, please welcome Hard Knocks Fighter, Wade Baldwin! This bout will be contested under amateur rules. The referee in charge of the Hard Knocks action is Mr. Elvis Lyon.
Fighters to center the cage. I want a good, clean, hard fight, give it everything you've got. Three rounds of hard action. If you want to touch gloves, touch them now.
Both fighters touch gloves in the center of the cage. Elvis Lyon, the referee for our main event, as Felix Jimenez comes out of the blue corner in the white trunks, and it's the white Hayabusa shorts out of the red corner for Wade Baldwin. These two amateur fighters touch gloves in the center of the ring, and immediately Baldwin comes forward, and Felix Jimenez throws a punch that lands to the right side.
And a good kick there. Baldwin caught it and took some shots for his efforts, and Felix definitely getting the better of the shots in early.
Felix landing the better of the strikes early. Another knee to the midsection of Baldwin. Baldwin goes down momentarily, but is up again with Felix having him up against the cage, looking for the guillotine choke. Felix leaning back with everything he has, trying to keep Wade Baldwin from getting out of this position. Baldwin takes Felix to the ground, but Felix still has Baldwin's neck.
And Felix not letting go of that hold. He's pretty happy about that hold. He's trying to bring him down. Now he does go down, but he gives up positioning. Now it's Baldwin trying to take advantage.
Baldwin now has Jimenez up against the cage, looking to do damage there. Again, in tight, Baldwin very powerful and a very good boxer. Felix Jimenez knocked out twice so far in his MMA career.
And again, going for that choke, trying to bring it down with the head. He's getting positioning, but not doing as much damage as he would have hoped, I don't think, for Jimenez. And now Baldwin's got his head free, now trying to get his arms free.
Again, another headlock for Felix Jimenez, trying to crank on that neck and secure the choke, putting a lot of effort into it here as he tries to get Wade Baldwin to tap and submit. Jimenez taking him back. Baldwin not giving up yet. That choke not exactly in the right spot as he's trying to knock it in there, but Jimenez with a nice knee to the midsection again, trying to soften up his opponent.
And Jimenez being very aggressive here. He quickly going for those chokes, and now he's just trying to bring him down here. I think he better off. He brought him to the mat and went for this choke. He's wasting a lot of energy, and he's got another big reap here. Wade's not moving too much.
Leaning back with everything he's got.
And he just asked the official to ask him.
But saying Wade was out and he was holding him up, but that not the case, as Wade continuing now to press forward, looking for a single leg. Baldwin scampers out and gets across the cage. Jimenez with the bring it on gesture, and Baldwin returns it. These two are looking for a war here in our main event with just 30 seconds remaining in round number one.
I think both men a little gassed after that exchange. There is a full 2 minutes of grappling as we're under 25 seconds, and now they reconvene and some more kicks and punches exchanged.
Well, just a couple seconds remaining here in round number one. Baldwin breathing heavy, having to fight off those choke attempts. Jimenez also having to gas his arms. And you got to wonder how much he'll have left as round number two will get underway in just a couple seconds. Baldwin tries to come in with a big punch to end the round. And that is the end of round number one. We'll head to round number two in our main event between Felix Jimenez and Wade Baldwin.
Wow. And we'll see a lot of factors in the opening minutes here. Right now, Felix has his hands on his hips. Not a very good way to start the round, but he looks like he's ready to go, and we'll see if one man can capitalize on the other man's tiredness here.
Baldwin coming out. He throws the first punch and gets one in there. Felix throws a big punch back as Baldwin is coming in. We know Baldwin's got a chin, but Felix is landing bombs. Jimenez trying to knock out Baldwin. Jimenez just throwing bombs, and every one of them connecting here early in round number two.
A really good right hand there. Got it right in the chin. Now Baldwin laying it in here.
Huge uppercuts coming from Baldwin up against the cage. Jimenez holding him off. And Baldwin now looking for the takedown, has the single leg, but it's Jimenez securing the takedown and ending up inside control.
Just when you say both men are tired, they both just lay out a fury of hands there, and now they're on the ground again with Jimenez on top, and we'll see if he can get a full guard or full mount here, right now with just the side control against the wall.
Jimenez tried to move up into the mount, blocked by Baldwin. Referee Elvis Lyon pulling some hands off the cage. Not sure whose hands from this angle. Jimenez on top, trying to find some work. Trying to find an opening here.
It's a pretty awkward position for both fighters here. Felix's strong arm is kind of buried on the wall there. So he goes, well, I got my knees, so I'm going to knee in the ribs.
Big knees coming from Felix Jimenez. And we mentioned the kicks. Those kicks have knees in the middle, and Wade Baldwin is feeling them now and finally moving to try and take something away from those knees. Wade Baldwin up against the cage. If I'm Felix Jimenez, you've got to be continuing that strategy as it seemed to be working, and it's going to do nothing but good in the eyes of the judges. Another rib to this side, another one to the rib cage. Felix Jimenez keeps dropping knees on Wade Baldwin from this side control position.
And for a man who's already tired, these extra shots to the ribs, it's got to be painful and is draining for Wade Baldwin. He's got to find his way out of here. And if a man the size of Felix Jimenez on top, that might be a difficult task.
Well, if you can't draw a full breath, you can't feed that muscle system that he's got there. And Wade Baldwin almost looked like he was trying to throw up an arm bar, but was unable to do so. And Felix Jimenez, again, still inside control, still putting knees into the ribs of Wade Baldwin, who's looking over at his coach, Derek Daku, in the corner for advice. and a nice sweep there from Wade Baldwin. Now he ends up in a side control of his own. We'll see what he can do with it as he's trying to mount Felix Jimenez and does so, and now he's going to start raining punches. Not much time left here in round number two as Wade Baldwin and Felix Jimenez going at it. Baldwin in the mounted position trying to drop bombs on Felix Jimenez, who, like I mentioned earlier, been knocked out twice. And just a few seconds left, that is the end of round two.
Last round, both men got to give it their all here, because it could be a pretty close score if you go to the scorecards if you need to.
Both fighters getting a last word from referee Elvis Lyon before he sends them back to his corners. And we are just about underway here in the third and final round. Both fighters slow to come out as they get ready. Baldwin and Jimenez throw up their fists and they are ready to go. The crowd chanting Felix, Felix, Baldwin, Baldwin. They are into it here in Estevan as we look to blow the roof off of Spectra Place.
And these fighters looking like they're gonna let the other make the first move here.
Well, a very slow start here to round number three as both fighters probably a little tanked out. Baldwin goes to throw the right hand and Felix tries to secure the takedown as a result, but it ends up with Baldwin on top. A nice sprawl there from Baldwin as he's trying to get advice from his corner. Felix Jimenez standing up on his toes to take some of the pressure away from any potential arm in chokes.
And the official calling time here. Not sure what the concern is.
The official going over to the corners. And a 1 point deduction to Felix Jimenez for grabbing the cage. This could be a huge point in a deduction for Felix Jimenez, who may have been winning the first two rounds, but he certainly is going to have to win the third if he wants a chance to win this fight, because you can't guarantee what the judges' scorecards say, and with a 1 point deduction, that is a significant blow to Felix Jimenez's chances here in round number three.
Yeah, I think he's really got to press the issue here. If he sits back, you can't let the judges decide. He's got to make the judges give him this round, and he's got to be more aggressive in getting that feed, because if he just holds back, it'll be a bit too close to call, especially with that point deduction.
Well, we've seen this before with Craig Goodry and Mike Guy, both fighters too tired to fight. Not sure if that's what's going on here. Both fighters, neither one wants to make a mistake. Boos coming from the crowd now as neither fighter has thrown a punch in the better part of a minute. It's Felix landing the better of the two punches in there, but the best punch coming from Baldwin on the uppercut shortly thereafter.
And again against the wall here, Felix is trying to bring him down, but Baldwin trying to pull the arms away from his legs and trying to get his head free. There's a knee there that connected. More knees.
Knees to the midsection of Wade Baldwin from Felix Jimenez. And you got to think, with the lack of action to that point in the round, this final minute is going to decide this third and final round here between these two fighters.
And those knees by Felix Jimenez have been huge this fight. And that's what got the advantage here in this third round. And now again, he works the body of Wade Baldwin.
Has him up against the cage, pressing him there, knowing he needs at least another round if he's going to overcome that 1 point deduction for grabbing the cage. Has Baldwin up, trying to use wrist control. The referee will break them up. Blood now coming from the nose of Wade Baldwin, and that's got to drive Felix on as he knows he's weakened Baldwin. With just 15 seconds to go, they're going to bring it out. Jimenez standing with his hands on his hips, waiting for Baldwin to engage. Just 10 seconds left here in round number three. And again, the quick fist from Felix, and Baldwin with everything he has in the final seconds of round number three. Both fighters throwing with everything they have, trying to get a last second knockout. This fight is over, and it will go to the judges' scorecards. They called it the main event for a reason. People getting what they paid for, on their feet for these two hometown fighters.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the official decision brought to you by TSNM. After three rounds, referee Elvis Lyon stopped this bout. The winner by unanimous decision, in the blue corner, Felix the Cat Jimenez!
More about Hard Knocks Fighting and upcoming Hard Knocks events, please visit hardknocksfighting.com.
What goes through your mind when the cage door closes?
I feel sick. I have anxiety and I just am praying and hoping that everything works out for the best.
How do you support Felix outside of the gym?
Well, I just give him the time and I do what I can at home so that he can do that. I take time off work so he can travel and train, and I just try to be there and take care of the kids that we have and try to make it a little bit easier for him, but sometimes it's hard to do too.
Next up, a return to our heavyweight division as we see Felix Jimenez take on Leroy Johnson. Ari, both of these guys very large and very willing to throw.
They are very large. There aren't many guys that I stand next to that make me feel small, and Leroy Johnson made me feel small. Now, Felix has a lot of experience in the Hard Knocks cage. When he's lost, typically it's because he's been out of position. I think he's been working on that a lot. And what I want to see is whether Leroy Johnson is going to be able to stay outside and bang on them, or whether Felix is going to control where the fight takes place.
So here it is, Felix Jimenez getting set to take on Leroy Johnson.
This school of Hard Knocks fight is an amateur bout in the heavyweight division, and is brought to you by Endurance Oil. And now, let's meet the fighters.
Felix Jimenez making his way down to the cage now. Out of Estevan, Saskatchewan, 2-2 as a heavyweight fighter, won his last fight against Wade Baldwin, and he gets set to step into the Hard Knocks cage against Leroy Johnson. Well, Felix Jimenez has been working his overall game, but he has really been working on his judo, wanting to use his judo in this fight. He knows Leroy Johnson is a striker. He knows that he's got that power, so if he can take it away by putting him on the ground, that's what he's going to do. The thing with Felix Jimenez is he wants to make a career out of this. He was a professional baseball player. Now he is in MMA. He wants to make a career out of it. There's not many gyms here in Estevan. He knows he has to push almost all the way to Regina to find a full-time gym to train in, but that's tough to do. The man is a family man. His wife is expecting their second child any day.
Yeah, and she was at the weigh-ins the other night making sure that Felix got weighed in properly, and you can see Jesse Bonfeld out with Felix. I believe Felix's wife's cousin is Jesse Bonfeld, so a little bit of training coming from Jesse as well as Felix gets ready. Interesting, Felix, of course, now with his fifth fight in Estevan, does live here in Estevan, was the centerpiece of the poster for Hard Knocks 31, and says he's feeling a little bit of pressure knowing that he is the poster boy for Estevan MMA for Hard Knocks tonight, and feels like he has to live up to that pressure.
Well, he didn't have much luck in his amateur debut the first time we came here to Estevan, but since then has rattled off two victories, and Felix Jimenez is a very good fighter, a very good athlete. As again, we talked about him being a two-sport athlete at the professional level in baseball, and you don't get there not being a good athlete, and he's shown that in his past few fights.
Yeah, very quick, very goes back and forth, was really able to slug it out with Wade Baldwin, won a three-round war where both fighters were absolutely exhausted by the time the fight was over, and Felix comes in tonight at 235 pounds and a little bigger than he was for his fight against Wade, and we'll see how that affects his performance tonight.
And his opponent.
Now we get to what could be the tallest athlete we've ever had in the Hard Knocks cage. 6'6", Leroy Johnson, came in at 251 pounds, cut from 280 pounds 2 weeks ago. This is a very big dude looking to continue his undefeated start to his career.
Yeah, his career started with two straight victories. His first opponent tapped to strikes. His second fight was a first round knockout. So this is a man with a lot of power coming from him. He's out of London, Ontario, out of Team Tompkins. So a very good fighter. He started as a boxer, and we've seen many boxers who have transitioned to MMA be successful because of that pure punching power and that technique to be able to land effectively to the chin of their opponent.
Yeah, Leroy Johnson steps into the cage tonight, says that he knows that Felix is getting better as a fighter and can't afford to take him lightly, but tweeted out this morning that if you dream about beating him, you better wake up and apologize. And so is ready to step into the Hard Knocks cage for the first time tonight. And again, a Team Tompkins affiliate. I asked him about the affiliate status, and he says Team Tompkins doesn't take on amateur fighters. You remain a Team Tompkins affiliate until you become a professional fighter, which is where he says he's going in his career, and is looking to get there with an undefeated amateur record. And in order to do that, he'll have to beat Felix Jimenez in his hometown. But now for the official introductions of this fight, here's Jay Denance.
And now, the official Hard Knocks fighter introductions. In the Power Dodge blue corner, he's 2-2 as an amateur, 33 years old, and stands 6'2" tall. He weighed in at 235 pounds, fighting as an independent from Estevan. Please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Felix the Cat Jimenez. In the Boston Pizza red corner, he's 2-0 as an amateur, 27 years old, and stands 6'6" tall. He weighed in at 251 pounds, fighting out of Team Tompkins Adrenaline Training Center. Please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Leroy Big Sexy Johnson! This bout will be contested under amateur rules. The referee in charge of the Hard Knocks action is Mr. Elvis Lyon.
So Leroy Johnson hearing it from the hometown crowd, firmly behind Felix Johnson, or Felix Jimenez rather, as Leroy Johnson and Jimenez get set to meet in the center of the cage. Out of the blue corner in the red tights is Felix Jimenez, blue and black and camo trunks for Leroy Johnson as they paw at each other early. And you see a big kick coming from Leroy. We know Felix likes to throw leg kicks, and there's a lot of leg to kick at on Leroy Johnson, Jeremy.
Yeah, and there he used a Superman punch to slip in to that leg. And now a nice takedown attempt by Jimenez in on the legs, but a lot of weight coming down on that sprawl by Leroy Johnson. And there's a takedown by Jimenez, and now working to get inside, and he's in the half guard now, but a lot of strength needed to hold down Leroy Johnson.
Big punches coming from Felix here. This fight is over. Felix Jimenez, your winner by TKO, as he dominates on the ground. Leroy Johnson finds himself with the first loss of his career, and Felix doing the dance in the center of the cage.
And a big action there by Felix Jimenez. Once he was able to take him to the ground, work that ground and pound, some great shots to the side. And like happens in a lot of knockout situations, you wake up and you have no clue where you are and no clue what happened. And you could hear the crowd here in Estevan, 2,000 strong, are just cheering on hometown boy Felix Jimenez as we wait for our official decision. But a big win by Jimenez here.
And now, the official decision brought to you by Endurance Oil. The winner at 44 seconds in the very first round, the winner by knockout in the blue corner, Felix the Cat Jimenez!
Felix Jimenez with the win.
A TKO victory, and for my money, Ari, a knockout, because Leroy Johnson was out before the ref stepped in. Felix Jimenez looking ever more impressive as his win streak continues.
Yeah, Felix did a great job of controlling where the fight took place, and once he got it down, he finished it in a dominant position. So I really liked it, and I think we ought to get Felix a title fight.
Well, there it is, Felix Jimenez with a title fight in his future after a knockout win over Leroy Johnson.
Well, that's it for another episode of Hard Knocks Rising Stars, where we get to see the progression of some of the best MMA fighters in the world. You can check out Hard Knocks Fighting on the web, on Twitter, or on Facebook. For all of us at Hard Knocks Fighting, including CEO Ari Tobe, my name is Jeremy Ballantyne, and thanks for watching.